Hello everyone, it's Mae Larson here, and I wanted to show you guys my teapot album that we created the other night while we were live for the Want to Scrap Teapot challenge between myself and Michelle Pipling. This is my teapot, and what I did is basically I took this fabric. It started out with this fabric here, and I picked this fabric at Joann's Fabric, and I used So here is the fabrics I used. I used this one, and then I used this one here. And this is about $24.99, so you definitely need your coupon code for that. This one wasn't so expensive, but I traced the teapot. I don't know if you guys saw. I did trace the teapot first onto the fabric on the wrong side of the fabric, and then once I did that, I cut it around. And the hardest part is going around the inside here. So you got to be really cautious on that part. Once I did that, I took and I did my GIMP. Now, the best thing probably to do is to wait on your GIMP until you get all your appliques and everything on there. Once you have your appliques, then go in and put your GIMP. So I took this trim here, which is this one. And I took the beads off. I just used that top one. And I used this one. That's a Hobby Lobby trim. This is also another Hobby Lobby trim. And I went around the inside of here and up here. And this is also a Hobby Lobby trim. And it's this one here. Okay. So once I had that, I applied all those in. I took a wedding dress applique. You guys saw me, it was a wedding dress applique. I put the wedding dress applique down. Then I took this one here, which is a collar from Shabby Chic Boutique. I applied my image and I went around the frame of the image with a, again, a Hobby Lobby trim, which is this one here. Okay. And then the collar is from Shabby Chic Boutique, which is this here. This one here, and it's a dangle. Then I took another dangle that is from Creating with Details, and I applied that dangle. And let me see if I find that dangle. Oh, let's see. I'm trying to find it, ladies. Okay, so this dangle here. Okay, so I use that one. You can get that one at Creating with Details. And then I took the beaded one from Hobby Lobby and I applied it on top of all those. And I took the pearl one and applied it on top of there. Then this jewelry piece here is from the Gilded Age, and you can find that in the jewelry section at Hobby Lobby. The image, I will put links below of where I purchased the image. And of course, my bows are using the DecoFun Bow Maker that is now available at the Want to Scrap store. You can check it out there and purchase your bow maker there. And I added a tassel here for my finishing piece and this Gilded Age jewelry piece on the top. So that's what I did in the front. Now, let's work on the back. Now, for the back, I have this piece of lace that was given to me by Karen Thompson. So what I did, I outlined around here, and I kind of went really careful, and I cut this piece here. Whoops. Have this piece. I see. I rounded it around. Have this piece. It goes right here. So when you're doing this, you have to be very, very cautious so you're not cutting into your GIMP or anything like that. Then I took this French lace and I cut that one on top of that, and that goes there. Just like that. That's going to be my pocket. So let's go ahead and let's work on that first. We're just going to glue right smack down the center. Now, I would like to let you guys know that Want to Scrap has all the new shipboard pieces available in their store. If you haven't done already and you haven't checked it out, stop by there. They have the Victorian boot, the full boot, not the shoe, the boot. They have that available. They have the sewing machine is available. They have a shabby bottle available in chipboard. They have the words epic now available. They have my funky hearts and my funky stars now available. So it's really neat how they've been able to do this. And ladies, I actually saw a video of how they actually do all this. The process is so amazing. I kid you not. It is an amazing process to watch them literally put everything through their laser cutter and cut the chipboard to the design that they put into the machine. So now we're going to go ahead and put this one on top. But yeah, it is awesome. I'm going to try to get that video uploaded for you guys. I've been having a little bit of computer problems, and we had really bad weather yesterday. So I'm hoping that we can get better quality videos now. My hubby's been trying to figure it out for me to see what I may have done wrong as far as pushing a button or something. I don't know. I don't know what I did. Who knows what I did? I know I did something. You need to stop by there and check out all the new products that they have loaded into their store. Their sewing machine is so stinking cute. I kid you not. It's really cute. You will totally love it. All right, so I have this pocket aligned just like that. See? It's a nice little pocket. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm not gonna glue down the first layer. I'm gonna make sure that I just glue down the second layer to the first layer, if that makes any sense to you. Make sure I do not glue down my pocket. So I kind of glued those two together. And now we're gonna decorate this baby. And I was thinking, let's see, what do I have, ladies? It's kind of hard to know what I have. I've had some new laces and stuff that's come in from various places, and this is a really beautiful one from Shabby Chic Boutique. That's really cute. Let's see, ladies. Well, that is really definitely cute there, and that would be gorgeous right there, I think. Let's see. Maybe too much, too overkill. Overkill. We don't want to overkill it. Well, let me take this one out. But let's see what else we can find that we can add underneath. Because, more is better. And that is for sure. And I like that. See that? I like that. So we're going to go with it. We're going to go for it. So I'm going to take this one here that I purchased from Shabby Chic Boutique. I'm going to go ahead and kind of trim just a piece of that. Try to glue that down. Doing a really good job burning myself tonight, ladies. So yeah, now they have the word epic available. They have the Victorian boot available. It is so neat to be able to see all those beautiful finished shipboard pieces come to life. It's just amazing. It really does. And the fact that they just listen to the customers and, they work diligently to get listings out for their customers. It's so awesome. All right, so I'm just gonna glue carefully glue this because we don't want to glue our pocket down, right? I'm gonna trim this one down just a little. And I'm shaping it to the shape of the teapot. So yeah, Michelle sent me a little video of the process of how everything comes to life in their warehouse, and it's so awesome. It's so awesome. All right, so we have a nice, lovely little pocket now. We'll go ahead and do this one. Those down. Okay. And then we're going to glue this one down. And these you got to be really careful because when you cut them wrong, you get beads everywhere, I've noticed. And I've tried to prevent that, but it's sometimes a little bit hard. So I'm going to go ahead and kind of nip this in the bud before I lose beads. Let's go ahead and glue here. And I know it's wide, so we're going to glue down here as well. So now we have that really pretty dangle going on there. Can't get enough of to bring that one in there. I don't know, I love this one. It's gorgeous. And I think this week all the bigger, lacier, the more expensive trims are 30% off at Hobby Lobby, if I'm not mistaken. Don't count me on that. Was perfect. Yep. So now that we have that, then we can go in and start decorating the inside portion. Okay. So we have this little pocket that we made on the live tutorial, and I have these little Velcros that you can purchase at Joann's or Hobby Lobby. And they come like this, and they're stacked. So you're just going to grab one, place it right in there, and just kind of run your finger, rub it through really good. Peel the adhesive backing to the one, and then carefully fold that. Again, you got to make sure you really get that in so that it sticks really well. Okay, once it's done, let's go ahead and make sure this is all completely glued though. All right. You should have a nice little Velcro attached to your little tea. This is a tea bag holder. So see, and then I added that piece on. Okay, so tuck it in there snug, and voila. So that's going to go in here, just like so, like that. Okay, but we have a little invitation. that we're going to work on. And these, again, I will post the link to these below this video. Let me see if I got enough to fit this one. Oh, yeah. I'm going to go ahead and peel the backing to this. And again, these are not fun to peel. Kid you not. So let's glue it down to felt. So you've got to have an important invitation to be invited to the tea party, right? So let's get this invitation printed off on fabric. And let's invite our special guest to the tea party. So I'm going to go ahead and trim this off. I can probably use that for extras because then I have these little things here that I want to enjoy tea. They're little strips. The only thing I can say about these are really cute, very affordable, is if you have the problems with your eyes, as I do, they're a little bit light. I think I would have done, again, I printed these off on a fabric printer fabric sheets. I would have done them a little bit darker, especially around those edges, so that we who can't see can see it. Because some of us have very poor vision. As I was telling you guys, I was so ashamed when they told me I had to wear glasses for driving. Not so much a shame as it was like shocker. It's like, I have to wear glasses, no way. Not for driving, not me. And you know what? In all reality, I really don't drive much. It does affect me just because I don't want to really admit that, you know, I've gotten to that age where I need glasses now. But I don't want to admit that I gotta wear glasses, ladies. I really don't. Alright, so they are kind of little. So you have to work it around. And work around your vision impairments. And then the lighting in this room is not the best, so even if it's day, it's still not. I don't have really good lighting in here, so that makes it. I'm going to say that because that could be used. Recycle, 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 right, ladies? All right, so we have that. Let's move this Velcro over here because I'm going to probably use it for something else, and let's attach a backing to this one. Now let's go ahead and use this here because I have it here, so why not make it part of this, right? And go ahead and glue this down. Get that juices there going. And push with my chin. Okay. Let's do that. And let's go in here.
here.
Get some of those glued down. All right, so let's trim. A scrap, we will scrap it, and what else do we have? We have this one that is from Shabby Chic Boutique. We can put that down here. Oh, that'd be cute. Absolutely. It's a nice little cute tassel trim. I hope you guys can see. Maybe I need to enlarge my. There we go. Now you guys probably could see me. See me? All right. I feel like I'm so behind. I'm running late for everything. Really late. I'm running late for an important date. No, I don't want that down there. Let's go with maybe adding that in the back. Would that work? No, that's not going to work. That won't work, and that was gifted to me by Marty. Oh, decisions, decisions that I have to make. I don't want to use this one there. I don't want to do that. I don't want to use that. Now, this one. Be stinking cute there, maybe. So let's do that one. Oh, look, I also have a little piece of this. That might look good there. Too short. Nope, won't work. All right. Let's put that one there. Need something in the back. So we're gonna go with that one. And this one's in the home decor section of Hobby Lobby, and I strongly recommend, ladies, do not pay full price for this one. It's pretty expensive. I think it's like $16.99. It is very gorgeous, but it is expensive, and it's one of those kind of trims that, you know, you have to hoard it because it's pretty pricey, and that is one of those that you have to hoard, hoard as much as you can possibly hoard. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and go around the edge, and we need to do our edge work, right? I'm going to go this way with this one. And this is a Creating with Details trim. And I'm just going to tuck it under there. I'm having second thought about this little trim down here. So it might be replacing that one, ladies. Just not sure about it. It's not doing it for me. So we're probably gonna go trim this here. I know. Decisions, decisions we have to make, ladies. But I am so finicky about stuff sometimes. So I'm gonna lift this one up here and I'm gonna try to tuck this one down here. Just like so, because it just kind of looks, it looked kind of bland to me. It needed something. It really did. So I'm gonna lift this up. Gonna tuck this one in. Then we're gonna trim the sides to suit that just a little. Okay, see, I like things to be even. I'm not sure about that either. I like my stuff to be really even. Okay, so I've decided to change and I put this little leaf trim there. Now I'm going to lift it up again and I'm going to put this one because I need some color and it's a pink mesh trim. And we're just going to squeeze it in there. What I love about these little tools, they're so handy. So handy. Get that there and then I'm gonna cut that's not cut right, me. Silly you. All right. There we go. Okay. We're gonna go that way, and then what we're gonna do up here, first I'm gonna take this little beaded one. I'm gonna put it right on that there. Turn it. For the top, I took an applique that I have here in my stash, and it looks like this. Let me make myself a little bit bigger, guys. Sorry. Looks like that. And I cut it like that. I'm gonna put that there. Make sure I got the right side. I'm gonna squeeze first these little kind of pleated. Close that up a little. First, I need some glue. And there we go. Then we're going to put that there. Just like so. Then, sorry, ladies. Gonna go ahead and take these pieces. Probably not. No, we're not. No, we're not. Probably go here. there. And I'll have that. And then for here, what I'm thinking about doing, I didn't know we got to cover that up, is not that. Let's see. Let's see, ladies. Let's see what we find that we can put there. Put a little bow. Let's do a little bow. And this is just one that was sitting here, and I happened to grab it. There. And we're going to, let's see, no, let's do this one. Which is from that Gilded Age. There. And grab this piece of a bead that is from One to Scraps bulk beads. I love these. Okay. One there. And one at the bottom. We have that going on. Okay, and it's a cute little invitation, and it says, "Dear so-and-so, you're cordially invited to tea." Sorry, contact RSP, I guess, but that's not RSVP. Sorry, it's cordially invited to tea. And contact RSVP. Kind of tiny little print, so I was having a hard time reading that. So, anyway, cordially invited to tea. And we can put enjoy tea in the back. Well, maybe not. Let's not do that. I think that'd be cute enough. We'll put that in here as well. Let's put that one first. Let's put our tea. But we need a teapot, right? So we have this cute little embellishment teapot that is available at the One Scrap store. And what I was going to do, moving all this, let's grab a piece of fabric. And let's cover that. Okay, so we are going to take this tiny little embellishment teapot. It's the Victorian teapot by Want to Scrap. And I'm going to take this scrap of fabric. Now, it is very, very tiny. It's an embellishment, of course. So you're going to, I recommend you trace it onto whatever you want to put on here. You can paint this as well. You don't definitely have to put fabric or anything like that on here. But I'm just going to go in here and do the best I can as far as cutting it. I'm going to turn it around the other way, and then I do the other side as well. They are tiny, so like I said, you can, if you don't want to do it this way, We can definitely also consider painting it, putting some stucco on it. Or stucco, I can't think of right now. I said that wrong, I know I did. That's what happens when you're constantly working, and you're exhausted. Your body doesn't think anymore. It's beyond exhaustion. I just can't tell you how exhausted I have been. I've been working nonstop. Very intricate. So just cut wherever you can. Probably for these kind of small cuts, I would recommend some scissors that are tinier and made for fabric so that you have a better control of it. I purchased some little ones and I didn't care for them, and they were in the fabric setting section, and gosh, I can't talk, and they're just not good. Try cutting into this and it's not doing the job. So we have to break out the big scissors. And I'm just cutting right around. I'm going to cut out that little tiny piece just because it was too tiny. And make a small slit there. And then just kind of squeeze in the scissors. Trim around. So we have that cute little teapot, and that cute. All right, so now we're going to do the same thing with the other one. Again, we're just going to trim out that piece that's there you go. Once you have this, it's easy peasy, right? Imagine. I'm gonna try to decorate this tiny little teapot. I wonder how that's gonna be. We shall see. Well, today was a better day, I can tell you that much. The sun actually came out, and I love the sun, ladies. I really do. I really, really do. Can't tell you how much I love the sun. It just brings energy to me. It really does. All right, we got that cut. Now, oops, we gotta do a little slit cut here. Got too carried away, ladies. Was like, yay, I'm done. All right. These are so neat. Really neat. It gives it a really cute, shabby embellishment to your album. Like, what little girl wouldn't want a little teapot album? My daughter would have. I already told you what she made us do when she was little. So I'm going to trim these out, the little legs. And I'm also going to trim out that there because I didn't use, I cut it. Got that. I'm going to glue it down as best as we can. And this handle's really tiny, ladies. So let's go with that first. Let's get that down first. So if Wanner Scrap is hearing me out, I think you need to laser cut some of these little pieces into fabric, and I think it'd be cute as little overlays. I think it would. Maybe we need to put a little, call it a Wanner Scrap and let them know we want it cut. We want some fabric, some of these cut in fabric. Easier if you start with your handles, work your way around. Okay. We have that cute little teapot. Now I'm gonna try to put some. Try. Let's see what we can do as far as putting some yam. I highly doubt that I'll be able to put some yam, but I also want to put some of this. Let's put some of this. And I can cut this one out. These are really cute, ladies. And I hope you guys are really enjoying these Wanna Scrap products. Tell us what you think. I mean, they listen to their customers, that is for sure. They're very good at listening to their customers' needs. We have that cute little teapot. Let's see. What can we use? We can use some of this because it's so tiny. We can also use. Yeah, it's so tiny. So tiny. Right. So off camera, I was having a little think, as our friend Michelle's always saying. And I took a piece of what was left from this dangle trim, and I cut it up and I added it here with one of the little flowers that was left over from this trim here. And I went around with the gimp, as you can see there. And I put that there, and I put two of one of Scrap's little beads on the top. Oh, that one's a little crooked. Hold on. Yeah, I'm kind of picky about that, ladies. So these are the one scrap flat back beads. There we go. And you can purchase that in the bulk bags. And that's that. And so we have this little cute invitation. So here's our page. And that's stinking cute. Here's our little tea bag, our teapot, and our invitation all in the back. And we're going to carefully tuck these in here, just like so. And we can't leave our little teapot out. And that's part of our little, you know, setup. I'm going to tuck that there. And there's our little teapot. Isn't that cute? I think it's stinking cute. So now it needs a bow. And this is not me. I'm crazy about bows, and I already have this one done. So we're going to put this one, probably again, up in the handle to accompany the other one. I use my DecoFun bow maker that you can purchase at Wancha Scraps online store, and it's available for purchase now. And I'm going to put a little pearl right there. I think it's stinking cute. Fluff out that. And that is that lovely page. And so we're going to be ready for this on Friday. And you will see the rest as we continue forward, ladies. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Until Friday night, see you then. Bye-bye.